Welcome to biology class. So today we're going to start a new chapter, root system. So before proceeding this, plant morphology are of two type. One is root system, another one is shoot system. When we study the seed germination, the first step, the seed germinates into radical, which leads to root system, plumule, which leads to shoot system. So all these we're going to discuss in this session. The root system is the descending portion of the plant axis. What is descending? The growing downwards into the soil, right? Is when the seed germinates, radical is the first organ to come out. It elongates to form primary or the taproot. It gives off lateral branches, that are secondary and tertiary roots, and thus form the root system. However, not all plants have their roots underground. Some plants have the root growing above the ground. These are called aerial roots. Like underground roots, these aerial roots are also responsible for absorbing nutrient, anchoring and fixing the plant by supporting them to the structure such as nearby wall, rocks. So in this slide, I just given a few examples of plants with the aerial root are bonsai, banyan tree, mangroves, etc. The root is usually an underground part of the plant. It is primarily responsible for the fixation and absorption of water. The root with its branches is known as root system. Now, we move ahead and look at the characteristic of root in various plants. Characteristic of the root. It is a positively geotrophic. What is this positively geotrophic? The plant which moves towards the gravity. That is geotrophic. It is usually non-green or brown in color. The root is not further differentiated into nodes and internodes. As per the rule, the root does not bear leaves and tree buds. This part of the plant is mainly responsible for anchoring it down into the ground and absorbing the essential mineral elements, nutrients and water from the soil. It is also used to store food. Without the roots, the transportation system in many plants would cease to exist. Therefore, it is important that you understand the need for root. However, there are more than one type of root system in plant. We will now look at them in brief. Types of root system. The root system is generally of two type. We will look at these two type in the section below. So here you can study the taproot and fibrous root. So pause the video and study this slide. See the taproot, there will be like arising one main root, that is a primary. It leads to the secondary and it leads to the tertiary. So taproot consists three types: primary root, secondary root and tertiary root. On next picture, you can study the fibrous root. So here you can study the cluster of roots. Cluster, that is a group of roots which is arrived at one area. That is fibrous root. So let us discuss each. Taproot system. It is the root system that develops from the radical and continues as the primary root, which give off lateral roots. They provide very strong anchorage as they are able to reach very deep into the soil. It is the main root system of dicot, example gram, China rose, neem. The taproot system develops from radical of the germinating seed. It is also called normal root system. The taproot system is present in only dicotyledonous plants. It is the primary and main root that develop from the radical. It bears many branches and remain underground. So here we study the other type of examples also, like sunflower, mustard, carrot, mango, etc. Fibrous root system. So next we're going to discuss another type is fibrous root system. In this root system, the primary root is short-leaved. A cluster of slender, fiber-like roots arise from the base of the radical and plumule, which constitute the fibrous root system. They do not branch profusely or shallow and spread horizontally. Hence, cannot provide strong anchorage. Fibrous root system is the main root system of monocot. Example, maize, grasses, wheat. Here I want to clarify one point. See, taproot, dicot plant. Fibrous root consists of monocot plant. So this will be the one of the main example of taproot and fibrous root. So based on that, you can classify the example maize as grass or the example for monocot and it as fibrous root system. Whereas carrot, China rose have taproot type of system. So that will be the example for dicotyledonous plant. Next, we move on to study adventitious root system. What is this adventitious root system? So this system which develops from any part of the plant body other than the radical is called adventitious root system. It is mostly seen in monocotyledonous plant. These are roots that develop from any part of the plant except the radical. They may be aerial or underground. They may grow from node, for example, money plant, bamboo. Stem cutting, example, rose. Tree branch, example, banyan. Or stem base, example, fibrous root in monocot. So this way, adventitious root develop. What does the root system consist of? Root system consists of primary and secondary root. Each root is made up of dermal, ground and vascular tissue. Root grow in length and width from primary and secondary meristem. So based on this dermal, ground and vascular tissue, we will see in next video. Function of root. Following are the important function of root. Root perform various functions that are necessary for the survival of the plant. They are an integral or integrated system that help the plants in. First, we're going to discuss about anchoring. Roots are the reason plants remain attached to the ground. They support the plant body, ensuring that they stand erect. Next, we're going to discuss about absorption. Primary function of the root is to absorb water and dissolve minerals from the soil. This is crucial as it helps in the process of photosynthesis. Storage. Plants prepare food and store in the form of starch in the leaves, shoot and roots. Prominent examples include carrot, radish, beetroot, etc. Root performs the following functions. Root absorb water and nutrients from the soil. They anchor the plant firmly to attach to the soil. They help in storing food and nutrient. Roots transport water and minerals to the plant. Students, next we're moving on to the interesting session. Here I'm going to ask some questions to brush your mind. What are the primary and secondary roots? Pause the video and think. I repeat the question. What are the primary and secondary roots? Students, come, let me check the answer. Primary roots are the early roots in young plant that consist of taproot, basal root and lateral root. Secondary roots are the side branches of primary root. Next, we're going to discuss one of the interesting diagrammatic questions. Students, next question. Pause the video. Identify the picture given. Option A and option B. Yes, observe it correctly. Okay, now I'm going to reveal my answer. Option A, fibroid root system. Option B, taproot system. So these are the two type of root system. Plants are sessile in nature. It means it fixes into the soil. How? With the help of root. So here we studied about characteristic feature of root and types of root. It includes taproot system and fibrous root system. Thank you.